just made a really depressing post on Facebook. And sometimes I'm like, that's depressing, no one wants to see that shit. And I delete it, but I'm not gonna do that today. I'm uploading a video to YouTube. La-di-dee. Okay, so we got our basic chart. If you're watching this, I'm sure you've seen me post the charts. Just, you know, I feel bad that I don't, when I finish filming this, I feel bad that I don't go in and edit a picture of the chart so you can see what I'm working on, but... Exactly 5 o'clock a.m. and I took a Klarna. You know, the Klarna should be, if it's not fully kicked in, it should be fully kicked in within the next 5 minutes. And I had a Coca-Cola. I just evened it out. Like, the Klarna can kind of like make you, I'll just say tired. Like, you could say zombified or drunk or whatever, but it just makes me tired, but usually not tired to the point where I want to sleep. Anyways, but the Klarna and a Coca-Cola, I drink way too much caffeine, but it basically puts me into a place that I feel either optimal or, you know, in a good place. So this is a very difficult one, and I can do it, it's just very hard. Okay, enough time with that. I think if you've seen my other videos, you have seen that I've pulled it off before, and I was just really straining my hand, because you have to not only stretch, but also push with the stretch. And I think I've like full, I played it to what I felt was proper toning or voicing, whatever you call it, when the notes are pressed down correctly. I think I've done that at least once, which is why I say that I know that chord, even though it's still a struggle. together. I think the root E is this. So anyways, they're all bunched together, and early on I was having trouble because since they're bunched, all you have to do is like lift one finger or move one finger over. And early on I was having trouble. I'm not used to thinking about my hands in terms of fingers. Like, I've had my hands my whole life, obviously. And what I use my hands for is usually picking something up or typing on the keyboard or whatever. And, like, it's a unconscious reaction. So anyways, I'm becoming more aware of my different fingers. And, I'll show you. If you can see, I know this is a long distance, but here, this is E minor. And then that goes into E major. And then if I want to go to E7, I lift my ring finger. And when I was first starting out, I would say, oh, I want to go to E7, I'll lift this finger. And I would lift my index finger. And then, that's not what I want. Get what I'm saying? Yeah, anyways. So let's start over. Caffeinated, which is why I'm not doing the water down the duck's back strum. I'm doing the pick by pick, which it's just more primal. That's the best way I can put it otherwise. Just heard there. I don't know if you heard a bit of dissonance. I don't know the proper definition of dissonance, but I think I'm using it right. So I wasn't fully pushing down on one of the notes, so I think that caused dissonance. And make sense of what I'm saying if I'm using the wrong word based on the sentence. Anyways. So I wasn't pushing down on one of the notes fully, which was causing dissonance. But aside from that, that's the rough sound of what it should sound like. I don't know why I'm explaining this to you. told before. It was a sob story I was talking about when I was first picking up the guitar and trying to learn it, about how we used to have a piano, and I played like I practiced, and whenever I made a mistake, my dad would yell, start over, and it killed the joy out of it. Anyways, that was when I was like 7 or something, and I'm 30 now, and I'm telling myself to start over when I make a mistake. Not all the time, but it's not killing the joy, that's not the point of the story. The point of the story, I guess, is maybe my dad had good advice, but he just didn't understand. I think my dad is very smart and knows a lot of facts, but he's not that, there's not very much intuition or abstract thinking. I think those things he's weak at. I could mute with my thumb, and I don't like doing that for some reason. And someone said, or I read somewhere, that basically you don't need to mute with your thumb if you don't want to. A different way of achieving the same effect is just being like very conscious of where your pick is and where the strings are. And just avoid, like, when you get to the point where you're not supposed to play the string, stop. And I'm not saying I'm that conscious, and I think doing that requires a lot of skill, and it actually probably requires more skill than muting with your thumb, but that is my preferred method. So, I can't tell if we did D twice, but we have D down pretty good, at any rate. And this is like, I don't know where to start count how many practices I've done today. I think it's the second since I slept, but as for a 24-hour period, I don't know how to judge these things. Thank you. now from the previous practice that this is a C, a difficult C, but it's just my, the weirdest part is my pinky bends in such an odd way. Okay, let me show you up close. Sorry about this. So this is how I'm holding it. And you see how my... Let me just step in. I shouldn't be stepping in my guitar case. Okay. So, when I'm trying to get this note, I want my pinky to go down. And like that. And you see how my pinky is bending like that? That doesn't seem right. I don't think it should be doing that. Or maybe it should. I mean, I've achieved the note with it bent like that. But it's one of those things where, like, you think about the designer of the note, if the note was designed, and you're thinking, like, how did they intend it to be played? Sorry, I had my middle finger and index finger on the wrong strings for that part, but anyways, the part where I showed the camera. There's this weird thing where if you intellectualize the note the chord you're playing, you actually do worse. So I think I was just like seriously putting a lot of intellectual thought into how my finger should go. And maybe that's good in the long run. I mean, you want your brain to be thinking about that stuff. But when you really like get deep into like, okay, if this finger's here, the relationship of the fingers. I think it's better to strum not perfectly voiced chord than to not be able to strum the chord at all. If that makes sense. Which you can't tell me because you're a camera. C7 and C major, and like I said in another video, C7 can go into C major can go into C7 very easily just by adding a pinky, the same way E major can go into E7 by removing the ring finger. It's just like a tiny change. And I just found out there that when I go from C major to C7, my index finger, I don't know if it slips or like it's just My hand has changed position, and it seems like such a minor change, but my index finger has the tendency to start brushing up against the first string. I don't know why I'm telling you this. I mean, I guess I'm talking to myself. And I think I've met a lot of smart people who do that. Okay, so that progression, it's definitely not something that would be used in a song, I'm pretty sure, but that progression from first string one, first string two, first string three, and then sixth string and fifth string at three and two, respectively, that progression, comes from different charts. I think each one of them is a different chart that I learned it from, because I grabbed these charts off the internet. I just Google image searched. So just by chance I found the connection there. So yeah, people were really confused as to why I was learning by grabbing all these different chords, chord shapes, whatever, why I was trying to learn that way. I don't know how stereotypically you start to learn, but whatever. They were confused by this weird, almost schizophrenic, like Hollywood schizophrenic, chart thing that I made out for myself. And they were like, why are you doing this? But it turns out you can learn this way. Like, later on in the video, I will be working on Caged, which is like, everyone's saying, a lot of people are saying, like, you need to learn this. This is really good. This will help. And I believe them. But I'm saying just learning individual chords or chord shapes, there's good stuff about that too. Just to appeal to my vanity, I was saying how I struggled with G major for weeks before I got it, and the Caged thing that I'm going to go to later is going to be an even bigger struggle. Okay. And I was thinking I might want to get a microphone because I'm starting to think, like, a lot of the stuff that I like when I'm playing it and I hear it in my room and it sounds good to me. I mean, obviously I'm a narcissist, but when I watch it on the TV computer, it sounds terrible. And I think a microphone might help with that, even though the microphone on this camera seems fairly decent. Okay. So, there's two more G's that I have on the chart, but I'm skipping them because I'm pretty sure they're part of Caged. And I'll learn that when I'm at that part. I don't know how big this toy was. It was like, I think his name was Flex Armstrong, and his arms were made of this flexible material, and he was like he looked like Duff Man, I think, if you know Duff Man from The Simpsons. So like basically a muscular guy, and you could stretch his arms out. Anyways, I feel kind of like that with this guitar. Like, I bend my muscles into, like, my arm muscles. You do realize there's, like, not thousands, but there's a shit ton of muscles in your arms and everything. Like, that's like grade 3 science. You know about those muscles. So anyways, it feels like when I apply those muscles in different positions to attain certain notes, it's like they get stuck there, and then when I try to go back to a more simple note, or I don't think it needs to be a more simple note, but just a different note, my muscle is already stuck at a certain position. Or maybe it's just that my muscles are tired. Anyways, let's learn. This is G major, and this is G major. These are both G major. And to me, they have a different enough sound that I would give them different classifications. I don't know how they decide those things. Anyways, we've been gapping a lot. perfect, but good enough. I think I need to chew this now. Hopefully that will work better. The break I took, but I think I played it well. I think I played it decently after I took the break. I took it a like 2 or 3 day break. And I don't know why that one is so easy, because it really feels like it should be a difficult one. Maybe I'm just cursing myself. Like. The guitar definitely has some magic in it. I don't know anything about magic or whatever 16th century occult level. When I say magic, I say like the computer has magic, or maybe it just means I don't understand it and I find it interesting, and the result of that is obsession. So that's the magic. Yeah. Toys R Us guitar, when I was learning it, it was acoustic, and the only thing I learned really was I spent way less time than I've spent on this so far, but the only thing I learned was the Star Spangled Banner, and I was fighting with it, and I was probably too stoned or drunk or like, it's hard to... You have to remember, or I have to remember, like, how much energy I put into drinking and smoking. Or, not necessarily that I put energy into it, that it took energy out of me by the act of doing it. So, I was really struggling. Something that, if I tried to learn now, I'd probably find it pretty simple. And I was over 20, so like, it's not like I'm talking about being like a kid and this difficult thing. Anyways, I was really struggling, and whatever way I was learning, they really emphasized you have to have your fingers as close to the tang as possible. And I don't know if that's specific to acoustic guitar, but with the electric, there's a lot more leeway, especially if you press down hard, or at least with this electric guitar, there's a lot more leeway. If you want to play a note here, so 1, 2, you want to play number 2 under the way I used to think it was supposed to do, and it still is good advice in general. But you have to play as close to the tang, this metal thing here being the tang, You have to put your finger as close to that as possible. And my point is, with this electric, or electric, I don't know in general, but with this one, instead of going like right next to the tang, you can go like halfway up. The more up, the more you're pushing your, the tolerance of, the great God in the sky who provides us with sound. Anyways, you can go up like halfway and still get a full rich note. And because of this, when you're, like, say you have to play, like, okay, what is, A major can be played like that. So the pinky all the way at the thing, the middle, or the ring a little bit up, and the middle a little bit up. But I just found, I don't know, let's try playing this. Okay. Yeah, so yeah, it can be played like that. Anyway, so for a chord, if you're stuck with, you need these three fingers and they're right next to each other, you can allow yourself to go up a bit. And this leads me to say, based on playing A7, which is this, where it's very easy for, it's very easy to have those two fingers right next to the tang. Oh man, I'm tired. I could use a cola or a cigarette. So since that's there, then you can take your index finger and just slide it into the middle, and then basically everything, each string is close, as close to the tang as possible. And I don't know if that is, I guess there is no official, there's no like Pope of guitar, but I just find that a better way to do it, especially when running through chords. Okay, so I'm gonna just go through G again and shut up. Oh fuck, we were past G, we were on B. I think we've even finished B and now we're on F. Okay. A scatterbrain. And F is nice and easy. It's a nice, like, if music is escalate and de-escalate, going from E to either A or D, it doesn't matter which, to C, to G, to B, to F, it's a good, like, escalation, and then, you know what I'm talking about. Paranoid, you don't know what I'm talking about, but you know what I just explained. B7. I was told that's a good transition. I don't know if he meant like do B7, a few different notes, and then end in A major, E major. I'm getting loopy. Okay, we're almost done this chart. I'm sorry I keep talking. You don't have to say everything that enters your mind, even though you have no one to talk to in real life. No, I might be hanging out with one of my friends soon. And it's basically... Thank you, camera, for still working and not making me get up and turn you back on and all that. And please do not interrupt me. I'm almost done. I know I've been taking a lot of your time. Jesus, I'm starting to anthropomorphize technology. Changing how I play guitar. I understand what she's doing now. She's not doing that. This is what I thought she was doing. But no, what she's doing is... Basically, the... So you see how there's like a aftertone to that? She's letting the aftertone play for a second, and then she immediately just presses down like she knows it. She obviously knows where to press, like, boom. Like, she knows it perfectly, and I don't know it that well yet. But so she lets the aftertone ring, and then perfectly presses strums, and that's why I still have a long way to go. That's where we are. Okay, so that's that. And technically we have two more charts, but I don't know if my camera will be that forgiving. So, what we do first is we play the root chord of C, play all the root chords. Playing the wrong root chord. Okay. Well, thank you. Yes, for some reason this is confusing. Let me see something. Yeah. Okay. So, if I'm doing this one, or I guess if I do multiple videos a day, it's not one today, but anyways, even if I do this like 3 times a day, this is gonna take a long time before it's in my head. There's there's all the cities. Okay, now. I'm not sure I really want to do this right now. Sea, that's funny. Talking about double entendres. So like I was explaining before, this might help. But then how does one's finger manage that? So yeah. Like, well, I did the stretch. I think that's the stretch you need, and I honestly don't know how you do that. I've seen it done in video, and the guy just messed up different hands. Like, I'm not saying it's impossible, I'm not saying I can't learn it, I'm just saying I can't do that right now. That is something I cannot do. yeah. This is even more insane. Okay, so I'll just, there, my hand's in that position. That's pretty much all I can do. And I was going to play the individual notes. So that's not a total waste. Still recording good. Okay. And the next one got 7, 8. Come on, we know where 7 is. Stop counting. For CCCI, at one point we're gonna go. I think this is the one where I was able to do it. So, yeah. Turn here. basically that is obtainable. I did try, and I got very close. The closer to the knuckle, the problem with bar chords is the first and second string. Your knuckle is, oh right, I remember how I got past that. Okay. So that. I know I messed it up, and I know I could spend more time on it. I am legitimately tired. This might be what my friend was talking about, how practicing while tired, you don't learn anything. I don't think I'm so tired that I'm literally learning nothing, yeah. And I also don't believe the statement that you learn nothing when tired. Even if I was like tired, I think if I practiced, I'd learn something. Just two more. So 10, 7, 9, 10. I'm allowed to count that, come on. I'm not used to this slow. C bracket A. I don't know what a lot of the stuff means. very not right way. I did it like maybe 5% right, and that's enough for now on that subject. Now I'm tired and I should turn off the video, but I'm a bit of a masochist and I want to figure this out. This is something I did for myself. Well, this is basically what I was just working on. Basically, I can't do that yet. I'm just going to close this window because it's full of very complicated chords, and I already have a lot of very complicated chords that I need to work on. And I just did. You saw me! Okay. And I must remember that this, at one point, was a very complicated chord. That's all. I'm really tired and I don't know why I'm not stopping. Could be a symptom of my mental illness, and I don't know why every video I pick my nose. I think the guitar makes my nails grow and snot dry up and form in my mouth, my nose. I'm disgusting. Thank you.
told you I was tired.
Where'd it go?
Oh, please don't disappear.
I was into it too. I'm sorry. This is my favorite D. But when I jam out, I don't go to it because like it's either not intuitive or I don't think I've come across another shape on the fretboard, whether vertical or horizontal, that uses that fingering. Anyways, I am really gonna stop now and have a Coke and a cigarette. And fuck, it's 6 a.m. This must be a really long video. Yeah, it's over an hour. Okay.